Hello friends, welcome back to our CCNA 200-301 series. Today is day 30. In day 30, we are going to discuss about dynamic routing protocol, some theory and basic concept. Okay, so let's start. Dynamic routing protocol. We use dynamic routing protocol in our router to learn automatically the networks. Example, if I have one router here, R1, and another router is R2, I have two router. We need to do configuration, right? We will do the IP, we will assign the IP to this interface and we will assign the IP to this interface. Same thing we will do to another router also. And this router know about this detail and this interface detail. Example, if I have F0 by 0 and this is F0 by 1. So this router only know about these two interface. This router don't know about the other router interface detail. So what we done in our last video, we do the static routing. We do the static routing. We are saying the router, if you need to go to this network, you can forward the traffic to this interface like we done in our last video. But here, example, if I have many routers, example, if I have many router in our organization, so many routers connected to each other like this, so many ways, it is very difficult to assign the IP address. We need to assign anyhow IP address, but it is very difficult to do static routing. It will take long time. If anything go wrong, it will be mess again. It will be have issue. So to overcome of these types of issue, we use dynamic routing protocol. See, static routing protocol, we need to do manually. Each and everything we need to assign. But whereas in dynamic routing protocol, the router is going to learn itself the automatically about the networks, and router is going to advertise the network to its interface automatically. If anything go down, if any new network added, automatically router is going to update its routing table and it is going to do the sharing of information as well as it is going to update the routing table. So this is the advantage of using dynamic routing protocol. If we have any issue, like if I use a static route, if anything go down or if we add a new network, I need to do manually, I need to remove or add or do something. But whereas in dynamic routing protocol, no need to do. We will add the network in our dynamic routing protocol. They will take care. If that network is going, it will remove from the routing table. If new network is added, it will add in the routing table. Routing table will have the best path. If anything go wrong with the best path link, that will be deleted from the routing table and it will add the new best path. Okay, some comments here. I put some notes here. When a routing protocol is used, router automatically advertise the best path to known network to each other, and router use the information to calculate the best path to the known destination. When any site link go down or update or any changes, router will automatically add to its routing table and router will automatically calculate a new best path, and they are going to share the network information. Router automatically advertise the available subnets to each other without administrator having to do manual configuration. So router is going to do automatically when it is configured dynamic routing protocol. If a subnet is added or remove or delete or anything go wrong, router will automatically discover that one and update in the routing table. And if the best path subnet go down, router automatically discover the new best path and calculate depending upon the new path, it will be stored in the routing table. Okay, so now let's see the what are the different types of routing protocol we have, then we are going to discuss about that one. See, we already discussed about the different types of routing protocol. That is dynamic routing protocol. We have interior gateway protocol, exterior gateway protocol, whereas interior gateway protocol again divide into distance vector routing protocol, link state routing protocol, and distance vector routing protocol. We have RIP and RIP version 1, 2, and IGRP, EIGRP, whereas here we have OSPF, ISIS, and path vector routing protocol come in exterior gateway protocol, that is BGP. So let's see here. Routing protocol divide into two, that is interior gateway protocol, in shortcut we call IGP, and one more is exterior gateway protocol, we call as EGP. And IGP are used for routing the traffic within the organization, that is within the company. If we want to run, we will use IGP, that is Interior Gateway Protocol. Whereas Exterior Gateway Protocol we use to routing the traffic between organization over internet, means outside the company. The only EGP is used today is BGP. This is BGP. That is Border Gateway Routing Protocol. Okay. Border Gateway Routing Protocol we use. An Interior Gateway Protocol can divide into two types, that is Distance Vector Routing Protocol, Link State Routing Protocol. And if you see Distance Vector Routing Protocol, that work on the Bellman-Fort algorithm, and Distance Vector Routing Protocol periodically update, and it is a class full routing protocol. Full routing table is going to exchange. If anything go down or up, they are going to exchange full routing table in this Distance Vector Routing Protocol. And they update the information through broadcast, and example is RIP1 and RIP2. Whereas Link State Routing Protocol, it work on Dijkstra algorithm, and Link State Routing Protocol update the link information, and it is a classless routing protocol. Classless means it support the subnetting, and it exchange the only missing information. It will not exchange the whole routing table. Whatever is missing, they will exchange only that information. And updates are through multicast. It will do multicast, not broadcast, whereas this one is doing broadcast. So it will do multicast. And example is OSPF, ISIS. And see here, all of IGP do the same work. Here I want to say that all IGP will do the same work, but depending upon the different types of company we select. But RIP is not advisable to use in the production network. We will use in production network OSPF or EIGRP. Okay. And what more? The router may receive multiple possible path to the destination network. Only best path will make in the routing table. This we already discussed, and the different IGP use different method to calculate the best path. They have matrix. Depending upon the matrix, they are going to calculate. Each possible will be assigned to a matrix. Example, for RIP, we have hope count. RIP will use how many router we have. Depending upon that one, he will decide. Example, see here. I will take the 2 router or 3 router. Let me take the 3 router. See here, I have 3 router. One router is here. Let me change my pen. Let me bring the small pen here, nip. See here, I have router 1. That is, this is R1. I have another one is R2. And another one is R3. Okay, this is R3. I can go like this. Or I have one more router, that is R4. I will write this as a R4. I have this path like this, okay? So if I want to go, to R3, I can go from R1 to R2. This is 100 Mbps. I will write 100 Mbps. This is speed. And here also 100 Mbps. And whereas here we have 10 Mbps. And here also 10 Mbps. So speed is up. I have more speed in the uplink, and this is the down path is less speed. Whatever router is going to count the hop count. Hop count means the RIP protocol is going to use hop count. Means he will count the how many router he is getting. Example, if he is starting from here, he want to go here, he will count 1 and 2. So he will say I am getting 2 router. Okay, and from here also he will count. He's saying I will get 2 routers. So they will go in any part. Example, if I add one more router here, let me add one more router. I have here example R5. So if I count from here, 1, 2, 3. So from here, if I use this path, we have 3 router. So if I use from this, I have 2 router. If I use this path, so RIP protocol prefer this path. RIP protocol prefer this path because less router. Even if we have more bandwidth here, speed is high. If we go from here, maybe we will go very fast because we have more speed here compared to here. But RIP will not follow this one. RIP will go from the shortest path. Means RIP is going to use the shortest path even if we have more traffic. If you consider, if you want to go to market anywhere, you will go with the shortest path. Even if you have many heavy traffic, you will use that one only, shortest path. You will not go longest path, but no traffic, you can go very fast. You can come very fast, but you will not use that one. So same path, same thing we have in RIP. So this is a disadvantage in RIP. They will check only the shortest path, even the speed is low, it will go to the destination with the shortest path. Whereas other routing protocol use the link state, they will check the link, which link is having the more bandwidth, they are going to travel through that one. Okay, I think you understand, but don't worry if you did not understand or if you have any confusion. When we start the detail about the routing protocol, we are going to discuss about that one. Just now remember, RIP use hop count, that is he will count the router to go the path. If we have two paths, one path is having less router and one path is having more router, he will choose the less router path, RIP, okay? And RIP is used by default 15. If we have more than 15 router, that one it will consider as a unreachable. So maximum we can use 15 only, okay? Hop count is 15. So see here what regarding OSPF metric, we say cost. OSPF use as a cost as a matrix, which is automatically derived from the interface bandwidth by default. And you can manually configure the cost to the link if you want to manipulate the path. So this one depending upon the bandwidth, okay? Whereas EIGRP use also bandwidth and delay. This both thing will be considered in EIGRP to calculate the metric. We will see in detail when we go in the each and every protocol, we are going to check how to calculate and what to do. So don't worry if you have any confusion, we will do that one also, okay? So now let's see what else we have here. After that, we are going to discuss routing information protocol, that is RIP 1, RIP 2 in coming video, and we are going to do the lab for RIP version 1 and RIP version 2. So in this video, we only learn advantage of the dynamic routing protocol. So I think you remember, right? Dynamic routing protocol use because automatically it will advertise, it will update the database. No need to do manually. If we have many router, it is difficult to configure the static route, and we will have so need to have so much time to configure, and we need to know destination. Here, no need to know the destination, just we will advertise our network on our router and it will automatically share the information and they will do automatically. If any link go down, automatically it will update in our database of the router. I think you have understand, right? If you have any doubts, don't worry, write in the comments, and when we go in detail for each and individual routing protocol, that time we will have more clear concept. Don't worry, but if you have any confusion, write in the comments so we will discuss again. Thank you very much. See you. Bye.